Hi there, my name is Mordy Oberstein and I am the head of SEO branding here at Wix. And today I want to show you our brand new SEO dashboard. The SEO dashboard is found under marketing and SEO under the tab SEO. Once you click on SEO, you'll be directed here to the new SEO dashboard. The SEO dashboard begins with a direct connection to Google Search Console performance data. Let's explore that data just a little bit. The data starts off with total performance over time. This data can be looked at over the last 7, 30, or 90 days. Let's have a look at 90 days worth of data. There are two data sets here. One are clicks, which is the number of times a user went to Google, saw a URL to your website, and then clicked on it. The other is impressions. This is the number of times a link or a URL to your website was displayed on the Google search results to a user. In this case, we have 206 clicks over the last 90 days and over 71,000 impressions over the last 90 days. What you'll also notice is that the total performance over time data from Search Console shows you the percentage change. So this 90-day period relative to the previous 90-day period saw a 3% reduction in the total number of clicks. Conversely, this data period, or this 90-day period that we're looking at here, represents a 1% increase in total impressions versus the previous 90-day period. You also have a trend chart here, which may show lots of peaks and valleys, but don't be too scared if that's what you see. Oftentimes, that's related to weekday or weekend user behavior. The next section of data within the SEO home that's pulled directly from Google Search Console helps us focus in on the most important data points within the overall Google Search Console performance data set. And it relates to both pages and queries. Let's start with pages. Here we're looking at, again, impressions, and we're looking at data over the last 30 days, but you could look at data over the last 7 or 90 days. And we're looking at which pages showed the greatest increase in impressions during this 30-day period relative to the previous 30-day period. And the top performing page has received an increase of over 2,700 impressions during this 30-day period relative to the previous 30-day period. And we can see which pages, by the way, have the inverse. Which pages lost the most impressions during this data period as compared to the previous 30-day period. We can also see this for clicks, both in terms of decrease in clicks and which pages show the most increase in clicks during this period versus the last reporting period. Let's move on to queries. Here we can see which queries, which search terms that people actually entered into Google produced the greatest increase in impressions for my website during this data period as opposed to the last data period, and which queries did I see the greatest decrease in impressions during this data period as opposed to the previous data period. And again, we can see the same thing both for clicks in terms of decrease in clicks and increase in clicks during this data period versus the previous data period, and which keywords are the ones that drove the increase or decrease in clicks during the data period. How might this be useful? Let's take a look at data from the last 90 days. And let's take a look at queries. And let's take a look at the queries that show the greatest decrease in impressions during this 90-day period over the last 90-day period. Notice any similarities here? Baidu SEO, SEO China, China SEO. Perhaps my blog post about how to do SEO in China is underperforming and might be in need of optimization. It might have been de-indexed by Google inadvertently. I need to go investigate and see. The data here can point you in the right direction to the most significant problems and can help you replicate your most significant wins all in one glance. Of course, if you want to head to Search Console and look at the full data set on Google Search Performance and well beyond all of the great data that Search Console has, you can click Go to Google Search Console and head directly to your Search Console data. Let's move down to see the rest of the SEO home. One of the unique things that the SEO home has done was to take all the SEO tools that we have inside of Wix and to aggregate them into one central location to make your workflows more efficient. Your SEO setup checklist, which includes direct connection to Google Search Console and instant indexing of your homepage, now appears here along with all the other SEO tools that Wix offers, including SEO settings, the URL redirect manager, the site inspection tool, robots.txt editor, and beyond. If we head back up to the last thing the SEO home has to offer you, and that is the educational widget. Here you'll get videos and articles to help you learn more and do better SEO, from tips to how to implement SEO practices, to articles that'll help you develop your SEO strategy, to new releases and announcements, on a Wix's SEO offering. On the Wix SEO Learning Hub, you can find all sorts of great assets to help you dive into the wide world of SEO, from SEO webinars to an SEO podcast to SEO content for both beginners and advanced pros that'll help you do better, learn more, and keep those rankings up and traffic coming in to your websites. And that completes our tour of the brand new SEO dashboard. If you have any questions or feedback, do let us know. We hope that the new tools, data, and educational resources will help you continue to grow and bring new traffic revenue to your websites.